This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Did you ever think you had the power to save lives? The ability to say whether or not a person lives or dies? Well, according to the gift of life, through organ and tissue donation, you do. Nicole Brewer tells us more.
In the Father, and Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. I thank you, God, for keeping me safe all day. Watch over me tonight.
Frank Garger and his family have a lot to be thankful for these days.
Since transplantation, there's not one thing I take for granted.
Now the picture of health and happiness, Frank's life wasn't always easy. As a child, he was diagnosed with a rare liver condition, an illness that worsened as he got older, and symptoms that were hard to ignore.
Jaundice, severe itching, diarrhea, no appetite whatsoever.
In the spring of 2002, Frank's health took a turn for the worst.
They noticed that there were lesions on my liver, white spots, and we thought it was cancer.
It wasn't cancer, but Frank did need a liver transplant.
The doctors told my parents and my wife that the liver was not going to last much longer.
Frank was one of 4,000 people on the waiting list for the Gift of Life region.
It was very emotional, nerve-wracking, once again not knowing what if I would get better or if this would get worse.
Today, there are nearly 102,000 people on the national waiting list. 15,000 of those people are living in eastern Pennsylvania, southern New Jersey, and Delaware. Senior transplant coordinator Tim Snyder says those numbers are simply unacceptable.
And those are our neighbors, those are our friends, and those are our relatives.
And while Frank received his liver transplant in a matter of days, some people die waiting.
And there's a health crisis in this country. That 17 individuals die every day who are in need of organ transplantation.
A lot of people do not make it because of the lack of donors out there and people, you know, willing to be an organ donor.
That's why Frank joined the Coalition for Donation, a subgroup of the Gift of Life program. Together, members raise awareness about the need for organ and tissue donors.
It's their goal to get out the word to the community, to the public, to whoever they can, that organ and tissue donation does work, and it does matter when you say yes.
The coalition also works to dispel common myths associated with organ and tissue donation. The most popular myth? That doctors won't work as hard to save you if you're an organ donor, something Tim Snyder says is completely untrue.
Gift of Life is notified only after it's been determined by the medical caregiving team, the physicians, that all medical possibilities have been reached in order to save that individual's life.
Other important facts? Donation doesn't change the appearance of the body for the funeral service. There is no cost to the donor's family, and all major organized religions approve of organ and tissue donation. So who can become a donor?
Anyone can be a donor. It doesn't matter how old you are or how young you are.
If you're thinking of becoming an organ and tissue donor, representatives of the Gift of Life say the first thing you should do is talk to your family about your wishes. You can place the designation on your driver's license, and you can do it from the comfort of your own home by logging on to donorsone.org.
There's information on there about becoming an organ donor. Talks a lot about Gift of Life donor program, the wait list. And then there's other avenues on that website as well that can direct you for further information should you so desire.
But aside from educating the public and creating awareness for organ and tissue donation, members say the coalition serves another purpose.
It's also a place where you can go that people know what has happened to you. You don't have to explain yourself to them. You don't have to explain why today is not a particularly good day for you.
Like so many donor families, Liz Kennedy knows the pain that comes with losing a loved one. Her 19-year-old son David was driving back from a class at Penn State University when he lost control of his car in January of 1992.
The coroner came to my home to tell me that my son had been in a car accident and that he had died.
Although Liz and her husband never discussed organ and tissue donation with their children, they decided to become a donor family.
The decision was based that something good would come of it, that other people would benefit.
And because of their decision, David's tissue has helped 45 people.
It's really a legacy that he is leaving to people. When he was alive, he had lots and lots of friends. And now these people actually have a physical part of him in them that is helping them. And that really makes it important for us.
And while they can't change the past, the Kennedys can take comfort in knowing that their decision to become a donor family has changed lives.
There's no better gift than the gift of life that you can give to a total stranger. It's really the most unselfish act.
And as Frank counts his blessings, he says he hopes his story will comfort those who have given and inspire others to do the same. For Tempo, I'm Nicole Brewer reporting.